Hello everyone and welcome back to Wildcard Workshop. Now, last time we set up sort of the framework for getting our targeting system working. At that point, we actually had a bit of a branch. We had two different paths that we could have taken. Well, actually, potentially more than two, but two that came to immediate mind. One could be seen as being a more appropriate choice, but then we would have had to do some less appropriate things to actually implement it. The other up front seems less appropriate, but it's actually more compatible and a bit less work. Now, what those two paths were was, one, we could have created new behavioral trees for the creatures to operate in the way that we want. The other is that we override their targeting manually without even touching the behavioral trees. Now, in the future, I do want to cover behavioral trees. This just might not be the most appropriate project for it. So in the future, if I don't find a project for it, I might just make a standalone episode on AI and behavioral trees in UE4 and how to work with them in the ARC dev kit. But for now, we're not going to do that. So let's go ahead and head over to the dev kit and I will show you what changes I have made to our targeting system.
All right, jumping right in. Let's see what changes I have made. Now, if you remember correctly, in the last episode, we set up our targeting list and added an event dispatcher that handles notifying things that have subscribed to it of those changes. Now, first thing, over here on our virtual buff, I've added two functions. One is setTarget. This didn't technically need to be a separate function, but I made it one just in case we find a reason to override the targeting list change. So what this does is we grab the owner of the buff, which will be the creature. We grab its controller, not a player controller, but Git controller where the target is the pawn. There's a few of these Git controller functions, so be careful which one you're trying to use. We cast it to Primal Dino AI controller, and then this has its own set target function. Now, I don't know if we need to bother with these bools yet. It doesn't seem like we do as of yet, but this might become something that we have to tweak later on, depending on the way it behaves, when we start putting it into more rigorous testing. Anywho, we call that we are calling it on the Dino AI controller, and the target we're setting is the input of this function. Now, we also created a targeting list changed function. Now, this is just an array of primal character references. We will get the index 0 and then set that as our new target. This may also get more complicated later on, but for right now, this is all we need to sort of see what effect we're going to have, or to see that it is even effective. So we'll start here on our sentry tower. So this is mostly unchanged, except for here at the end. After we have created the buff and then set a couple of the variables on it, I created a bind event to onTargetListChange node. This is for the event dispatcher here. And then I used the create event option here. If you drag down on this and you go create event, you'll get this little node. You want to drag the pin for whatever object is actually going to be doing the subscribing to it. Now, the way this works is you have to create a function for this, and the signature of that function, the parameter list, and all of the types have to match whatever the output of the event dispatcher is, and it'll show up in the list here. So I grab our virtual buff, and I plug it into the create event, and it will show this is the only event on it that fits the signature, so it's the only selectable option. Now what this does is this subscribes the buff, in particular that function, to our onTargetListChange event dispatcher. So anytime we use that, we call the event dispatcher, like when we add or remove to the targeting list, then everything that's subscribed to it will get a notice. It'll get an update. That function will be fired. Here in the eval for new pawn, I also added a bind event to undyed. for the foundation itself. What this is this is looking to see if any of our target list options die. If they do, it will fire an event for right here. This function will be fired. And what this does is it basically is similar to the pawn leave. If they die, it removes them from the target list and calls the target list change. So basically, we just notify all of the virtual creatures that something died and let it know the new target list. This is mostly because when something dies, it still leaves behind a character for a little bit. So, and it also is different from the overlap event. When a pawn leaves, we will clear that binding, just unbind all events from onDied, with the target being the pawn that left. Okay, so we're only going to clear the bindings from that pawn. So assign new target to stray. This function will be getting called during a particular scenario. We grab the buff, our virtual buff, for a stray sentry creature. Basically one that tries to leave the target area. Maybe it's picked up another target that's not on our target list for whatever reason. Basically, if it leaves the target area, we get a signal saying, hey, and we're going to tell it, hey, here's the set target. Oh, we did make use of that function. Okay, so we directly set the target on the buff this way. And end combat states. The change we made here was if combat has ended and we are we're removing the creatures from play, the virtual creatures, and we're destroying them. After their transition out event has been fired, we're going to unbind all of the events from target list change. Okay, this just prevents us from getting any null pointer crashes and stuff like that. And then, after we have removed the on target list change binding from all of the creatures that we just removed from our virtual creature list, which should be all of them, but something to keep in mind is that it's possible that another player has entered the area immediately, and we're going to call the on-target list change afterwards anyways, just in case there is anything new that has popped up. So when a actor leaves the overlap area, okay, we'll check if it's a virtual creature. If it is, oh, hey, that's one that didn't there. Okay, so I added this function as well, is virtual creature. If it'll take a character reference, cast primal item character, if it is in our virtual creature list. The reason I'm checking to see if it's in our virtual creature list, as opposed to just checking to see if it has the virtual buff, is because these towers could be overlapping each other in their effective areas. So we want to see, we only want this to pass through true if it is one of our own virtual creatures, because then it's a stray. If it's another creature that is, if it's a virtual creature belonging to another tower that is leaving our effective area, that doesn't mean it's a stray. It may still be within the effective area of its tower. So we want to check to see if it's one of this particular tower's creatures. If so, we will return true. Otherwise, this function will return false. Now, if it is one of our virtual creatures, then we're going to assign new target to straight. And, oop, there's a bug. Would you look at that? That wasn't even hooked up. There we go. So, there we go. Fixed a bug already. And then on false, it does the other functionality that we've already gone over. That is about it. Kind of ran through that. Let me recompile that. Let me just do one last once over. Just see if there were any other functions here. Oh, you know what? I could just look in here. Let's see here. Player... Nope. Okay, we only added those three functions right there, and everything else was modifications, and we went over all of them, I believe. Didn't add any new variables. So yeah, we should be good on that. Yep. So let's show how it works. Once again, this is going to pop up three clients for me. So it's going to There's going to be times where it drags along a little bit. Here we are. I've set up a sentry tower. I've put a crystal in there. As you can see, the player who made it is not triggering the sentry response right now, so we haven't broken that functionality. I'm going to step out of the area and I'm going to put it in view like this while I work with the other clients. Let's grab one of them right here. And then I'm going to drag him in there. We can see. Got a hiccup. I switched clients. It didn't like that. Okay, there we go. So he's in there. I'm going to lock this other one in there as well. Now, he's not doing anything yet, and that's because he's actually still in the transition phase. So give him a second, and he will. There we go. That'll be something. Oh. Now, I do believe I might have just... That was interesting. That was interesting. I don't know why he stopped there, but I'm going to have to look into that in the future. Also, holy cow, the sound. I'm going to have to see if I can quiet that up a bit. Okay, so... I mean, that worked. It worked. Don't look at me like that. It worked. You saw it. But something tripped up his targeting a little bit there. And it might have been that I had just barely left the effective area. The effective area on this is a bit small. Oh, let's see what happens. See that? If you leave the effective area, he stops targeting you, which is what we wanted. Oh, he's being despawned, that's why. So now it's going to spawn in another one. And then he's going to come after me. Or it's just going to stall for a moment. There we go. So. He's going to come and attack me here any moment now. I think. So that might be a bug to look into is... That they're only getting the targeting list change after they've been spawned. I could have sworn I actually already took care of that. So I'm going to take a look and see if maybe that change reverted on me. But I bet you anything. Yep, there he goes. So now he got the targeting list change on the overlap that occurred after he spawned. Oop, he's... Yep, there we go. But he did get the full list, so he went after everyone after that. So... Let's see if we can fix that real quick. Let's see here. What happened? Beyond spawn virtual creature. We bind it to it on the spawn. But... I don't know. Be under start combat state. Ah, okay, so here's where we fix that. Okay. Down here, I'm going to take this targeting list change. I'm going to call it. And give it the target list. And that'll fix that problem, because now all the creatures are spawning, and now they are getting the target list change. Because that was the problem, was we were calling the targeting list change as soon as the overlap happened. But then the creature was being spawned. So now, the creature's being spawned, all of the creatures are being spawned first, and then we are calling the target list change. So that will fix that problem. So I'm going to save and commit that change. But that's about it. That should get us mostly working. There is one issue where after killing a creature... like if it's the last, well, no, that didn't occur. Maybe I already fixed that. I don't know. I'll have to do some more testing. There's all kinds of little granular areas with this particular implementation that could result in bugs. So, you know, if anybody finds any bugs with it that I don't put up on the board here within the next week, go ahead and let me know. And I will make sure to check them out and put them up there if necessary. Now, as you can see, it doesn't work perfectly. There are still a couple little bugs.
in particular when things die. So I'm not going to fix it right away because right now I cannot see a way that that particular... Well, actually, yes, I can. I can think of one way that it could be abused. But we're not releasing the mod yet. So we're going to save that for a bug pass. What I'm going to do is in the GitLab repository, I'm going to log a bug on the board. And you should be able to see them. And in the future, I will go forward and take care of that. And going forward, anytime I notice these bugs as I'm developing these features, I'm going to start logging them in there. Now our targeting system is sort of working. Enemies or unauthorized individuals come into the area, spawn the creatures, and bam, they go. They tear it up. So until next time, happy modding.